Now we'll see the next topic, which is linear equations of the first order. Now see the statement of the theorem. The general solution of Cauchy linear equation, which is Lagrange's equations. Cauchy linear equation is of the form P of x, y, z P plus Q of x, y, z Q is equal to R of x, y, z. So this is linear in terms of P and Q only, so not linear in terms of z. Okay, where P, Q, R are continuous differentiable functions of x, y, and z, and not vanishing simultaneously, is f of u v is equal to 0, where f is arbitrary functions of u and v, and u is functions of x, y, z, which is equal to c1, v is function also of in x, y, z, which is equal to c2, are two independent solutions of the system. So this is solution of the system, dx upon p of x, y, z is equal to dy upon q of x, y, z is equal to dz upon r of x, y, z. Means what? If we have the given equation is of the type p of x, y, z, p plus q of x, y, z, q is equal to r of x, y, z, then we can write this equation in the form of this. Dx upon coefficient of p is p of x, y, z. Dx upon p of x, y, z is equal to dy upon this q of x, y, z is equal to dz upon r of x, y, z. And comparing coefficient, and we'll solve this equation. Now let's see. Here, what we have given? We have given that, so this is a linear, this is Cauchy linear equations, and PQR are continuous differentiable functions in terms of x, y, z, not vanishing simultaneously, is f of u, v equal to 0. And here, u is functions of x, y, z, and v is functions of x, y, z. So, is the solution of this system, right? So, here, u of x, y, z is equal to c1 is solution of equation number 4. Then, we have, u is solution of this equation. Means what? This u must satisfy this equation, right? So I will write this as, so this p as it is, and p is, this p is dy by z by dy by x, and this q is dy by z by dy by y, and this r is dy by z by dy by dy by r by dy by z. So okay, so here p is dy by z by dy by x, so we can write it as ux. So p into ux plus q into uy is equal to, here on left hand side I can write it as r into uz is equal to 0. So call this as equation number 5. Also similarly, what we have given, v of xyz is also solution, so it must satisfy this equation also. Okay, so we can write this equation as p into vx plus q into vy plus r into vz is equal to 0. So call this is equation number 5, this is equation number 6. Now solving equation number 5 and 6 by using Cramer's rule, what will we have? So p upon here, we remove first column, and then remaining will be uy uz, and here vy vz, which is equal to minus q times minus q, removing second column, we get ux uz vx vz, and last r upon here ux uy and vx vy. So after solving this determinant, we will get p upon uy uvz minus vy uz equal to q upon uz, means after interchanging sign numerator and denominator, we get uz vx minus ux vz equal to r upon ux vy minus vx uy. And so which implies that, so this is the Jacobian of uv with respect to yz, this is Jacobian of uv with respect to zx, and this is Jacobian of uv with respect to xy. So here we get p upon Jacobian of uv with respect to yz, q upon Jacobian of uv with respect to zx, and which is equal to last r upon Jacobian of uv upon dy by xy. This is possible because of the fact that u is equal to c1 and v is equal to c2 are independent solutions, and we know that f of uv is equal to 0, which leads to, so f of uv equal to 0, then it, from this equation we get the solution p into daba uv by daba yz plus q into daba uv by daba zx plus right side daba uv upon daba xy. Means what? So this is our value of p. So this is p and this is q and this is r. So we get solution p into Jacobian uv by dy by yz plus q into Jacobian uv by So dy by uv by dy by zx and last dy by uv by dy by xy. Now, so this is the equation is of the form pp plus qq is equal to r. So value of p is dy by uv by dy by yz, value of capital Q is dy by uv by dy by zx and value of r is dy by uv by dy by xy, where p is, value of p is, so value of p is this, value of q is this and value of r is this. Substituting equation 7, so this is equation number 7 into 8, this is number question number 8 and this is equation number 7. So we see that equation 2 is solution of the equation 1 if equation 2 is f of uv is solution of equation number 1, which is p plus q q equal to r if u is equal to c1 and v is equal to c2 are independent solutions of equation number 4. Now let's solve the examples. Find the general solution of xp plus yq equal to z. Now its auxiliary equation is, so our equation is of the form p of xyz p plus q of xyz q is equal to r of xyz. So we solve this example. So its auxiliary equation is this. So this equation can be written as dx upon p equal to dy upon q is equal to dz upon r. So value of p is x, value of q, capital Q is y and capital R, value of capital R is z. So dx upon x is equal to dy upon y is equal to dz upon z. So solving these two ratio, these three ratio, so taking any two ratios simultaneously we get, so taking first two ratio we get dx upon x is equal to dy upon y. So this is variable separable form, so directly I can take integration. So we get log x is equal to log y plus c, and after solving we get log x upon y is equal to c, right? So we call this as first solution. So it is u is equal to x upon y, which is equal to c1. Now next again find out second solution. Now taking any two ratios, so after taking last two ratios we get, so last two ratio we get dy by y is equal to dz upon z. This is again variable separable form. Now integrating we get log y is equal to log z, and then after solving we get log y log y by z is equal to constant, so which implies that finally we get v is equal to y by z. So we get actually solution y upon z, but we call this as second solution v. First solution is u and second solution is v. Okay, so here therefore this general solution can be written in the form of f of uv is equal to 0 or z is equal to y times f of u, or here f of uv equal to 0 or u is equal to g of v. So u is x by y and v is y by z. This is equal to 0. This is also solution, or we can write this also z upon y is equal to g of xy. Okay, means what? We can write solution is of the form f of uv is equal to 0 or u is equal to f of v or g of v. We can write in any ways. Okay, now let's see one more solution, one more example. Now let's see the question. Find the general solution of x square p plus y square q is equal to x plus y into z. Now first we'll write its auxiliary equation. So its auxiliary equation is p of x y z p plus q of x y z q is equal to r of x y z, right? Therefore its general form will be, so what is its general form? Dx upon p of x y z is equal to dy upon q of x y z and last dz upon r of x y z. Okay, so here what is our equation? X square p plus y square q is equal to x plus y into z. So substituting value here we get dx upon x square is equal to dy upon y square is equal to dz upon x plus y into z. Okay, now equating any two ratios and find out its solution. Now if we compare first two ratios, now let's compare, because here we have derivative with respect to x and y, and here functions with respect to x and y only. Now comparing first two ratios, it is too easy. So comparing first two ratios, then what will we get? Dx upon x square is equal to dy upon y square. And taking integration, so we get integrating minus 1 upon x is equal to minus 1 upon y plus constant of integration c1. So directly we get here minus 1 upon x plus 1 upon y is equal to c1. So we call this as first solution. This is u, or we can change the sign. So therefore you can write u is equal to 1 upon x minus 1 upon y. So we get solution, we can write it as minus 1 upon x plus 1 upon y, or we can write 1 upon x minus 1 upon y. So this is the first solution. So u is equal to 1 upon x minus 1 upon y. Now next, find out second solution. How to find second solution? So find out second solution. Now here last term is dz upon x square plus x plus y into z, okay? And so how to solve this? Now if we take addition of first two, then dx plus dy upon x square plus y square, and here if we compare this with last term, then we will get dz upon x plus y. But here x plus y cannot be cancelled. Now if we take subtraction of first two and add with equate it with last, then what happened? Now consider, now first dx minus dy upon x square minus y square, means we take subtraction of first two ratio and equate it with last, so which is equal to dz upon x plus y into z. Then let's see what happened. So here dx minus dy upon, here is its expansion is x minus y into x plus y, which is equal to dz upon x plus y into z. So x plus y get cancelled, so remaining term will be dx minus dy upon x minus y is equal to dz. Okay, so this is variable separable form. Okay, so here we get variable separable form. Now integrating, so integrating we get after integrating dx minus dy upon x minus y is equal to integration dz. So we get here log of x minus y, because integration derivative of x minus y will be dx minus dy. So the derivative of this function is this dx minus dy. So we get integration log x minus y is equal to z. Okay, therefore, and so here is remaining term is z. So g dz upon z. So here dz upon z, after taking integration we get here log z plus constant of integration log c. So take cancelling log, so we get, so here we get log of x minus y minus log z is equal to log c. I will call it is c2. Therefore it is log of x minus y upon z is equal to log c2. Therefore cancelling log, that is taking anti log, we get x minus y upon z is equal to c2. So we call this is second solution. Therefore here we get v is equal to x minus y upon z. This is second solution. Therefore its solution can be written as, its solution can be written as f of u v is equal to 0, or u is equal to f of v. Okay, means what? So here what is value of u? U is 1 upon x. So here its function, its solution is 1 upon x minus 1 upon y, and second one is x minus y upon z is equal to 0 is also the required solution. Or we can write it as in terms of z. So we can write it as, so here x minus y upon z is equal to c2, so we can write it also z upon x minus y is also c2 dash constant, right? So this is also solution. Therefore, it can be written as, or it can be written as f of 1 by x minus 1 by y, comma z upon x minus y is equal to 0 is also solution. Or we can write it as u is equal to f of v. So what is our v? So we can write u is equal to f of v, or we can write v is equal to f of u. Okay. So here this solution can be written as z upon x minus y is equal to z minus. So this is second solution. Z upon x minus y is equal to f of, second solution is 1 upon x minus 1 upon y. That implies after solving, so multiplying this on other side, so z is equal to x minus y into f of 1 by x minus 1 by y. It is also solution of given problem. Means what? So here, for that type of equation, means what? We have the equation dx upon p equal to dy upon q is equal to dz upon r has infinitely many solutions. So here we get more than one solution. So this is first solution. This is, we can write second solution. This is also solution. Means what? That type of equation we get infinitely many solutions. Okay. So here this is first solution. This is second solution, and this is third solution of same problem. Okay. Means we can write solution is of the form right like this. Next, also we can write the solution is of the form 1 upon x minus 1 upon y, comma z upon x minus y. Or we can write the solution is of the form z is equal to x minus y into f of 1 by x minus 1 by y. Or we can write solution 1 by x minus 1 by y in is equal to f of x minus y upon z also. Okay. So we can write in many ways. Now let's see one more example. Find out the general integral of, equation is z into xp minus yq is equal to y square minus x square. So it's auxiliary equation. So this equation can be written as zxp minus yzq is equal to y square minus x square. So its auxiliary equation can be written as, so its auxiliary equation is, auxiliary equation is, what is auxiliary equation? Dx upon p equal to dy upon q is equal to dz upon r, right? So substituting value we get dx upon p is zx equal to dy upon q is minus yz, and dz upon r is y square minus x square. Okay, now to find out its particular solution, general solution. Now if we compare first two ratios, if we comparing the first two ratios, then zz will get cancelled and we get the terms of x and y only, and we have the derivative with respect to x and with respect to y only. So we can directly solve. So let's taking first two ratios, then what we get? Dx upon zx is equal to dy upon minus yz. So zz get cancelled, which implies that dx upon x equal to dy upon minus y. So that is we get the equation dx upon x plus dy upon y is equal to 0. So which is variable separable form. So solving this integral we get, taking integrating, we get log x plus log y is equal to log c1. So we get log xy is equal to log c1. Taking anti-log, we get the solution x into y is equal to c1. So we call this as u is equal to x into y, which is the first solution. This is equation number one. So this is u is equal to x into y. This is first solution of given example. Okay, now next find out another one more solution for this v. Now how to solve this? Here what is our last value, which is y square minus x square. Okay, and here, so here is x minus y, right? So dx upon zx is equal to dy upon minus yz. If I take addition of first two ratio and equate it with last ratio, then what will happen? So now if we take addition of first ratio dx plus dy, and after taking, so denominator is zx, so sine is minus yz is equal to dz upon y square minus x square. So then what will happen, which implies that dx plus dy upon taking z outside, z into bracket x minus y, which is equal to dz upon, so expansion of this is y square minus x square, which is nothing but y minus x into y plus x. Okay, so which implies that, so taking minus sign outside here, we get, so dx plus dy upon z into x minus y, so which is equal to minus dz upon, so taking minus sign, we get minus x minus y into y plus x. Okay, y plus x means what, which is x plus y, so x minus y get cancelled, so remaining term will be dx plus dy upon, so here multiply this z on other side, so upon one only remaining term, and here, so here y plus x is divide all on other side, so we multiply on other side, so we get the equation x plus y into dx plus dy is equal to minus z into dz. Okay, so here we get x plus y into dx plus dy is equal to minus d, minus z dz. Now to find out its, so this is variable separable form. Okay, so this can be written as x plus y into dx plus dy minus z dz is equal to 0. So taking integration, now by substitution, so substitute x plus y is equal to t, then its derivative, so what is its derivative, dx plus dy is equal to dt, then in this equation after substituting what we get, so value of x plus y is t and dx plus dy is dt, which is equal to here is minus sign, minus z into dz is equal to 0. So this is variable separable form, so taking integration we get, after integrating t square by 2 minus z square upon 2 is equal to constant of integration c2, that is we get t square minus z square is equal to twice c2, so I will call this as c2 dash. So what is value of t, t is x plus y bracket square minus z square, which is equal to c2 dash, and this is another solution, that is v is equal to x plus y bracket square minus z square, so this is another solution v, and first solution, so this is called equation number 3. Okay, so our equation number 2 is xy, x u is equal to x into y, so this is first equation and this is second equation, therefore its solution will be, its solution is f of u v is equal to 0 or u equal to f of v, right? So we can write, so our u is xy, therefore its solution is f of xy comma v is x plus y bracket square minus z square, which is equal to 0. Okay, which is equal to 0, this is first solution, or we can find out other solution, x into y is equal to f of x plus y bracket square minus z square, this is another solution. Okay, so we get solution f of xy comma x plus y bracket square minus z square is equal to 0. Now let's see one more example, y square p minus xy q is equal to x into z plus, z minus twice y. Now find out its general solution, now its auxiliary equation is, its auxiliary equation is dx upon y square equal to dy upon minus xy is equal to dz upon x into z minus twice y. Okay, now if we compare first two ratios, then what will we get, then we get the equation in terms of x and y. So comparing first two ratios, then what will happen, dx by y square equal to dy upon minus x into y, so y get cancelled, so remaining equation will be dx upon y is equal to dy upon minus x. Okay, so taking variable separable form, we get minus x dx minus, so we taking this term on left hand side, so minus y dy, which is equal to 0. So taking minus sign out, cancel, so we get x dx plus y dy, which is equal to 0. So this is the variable separable form. So integrating, we get its solution x square by 2 plus y square by 2, so 2 cancelling, so which is equal to c1. So this is first solution, so I will call this as u. Therefore u is equal to x square plus y square, which is equal to constant of integration c1. So this is the first solution, so call this, so this is equation number 1, so call this is equation number 2. Now to find out second solution, now what can I do for solving second solution? Now here, if we compare first and last ratio, if we compare first and last ratio, so here this is, if we compare first and last ratio, then there is no terms of derivative with respect to y, and here is term with respect to y, so we cannot solve it. Now if we consider first and second and third, then there is terms of x, but here there is some complication in y, and here z minus twice y. Okay, now comparing second and third ratio, then what will happen? So comparing last two ratios, then we get dy upon minus x into y is equal to dz upon x into z minus twice y. Okay, so xx will get cancelled, we get, which implies that dy upon, so cancelling x, minus y is equal to dz upon z minus twice y. Okay, now so this is the differential equation, so I can write it as z minus twice y into dy, z minus twice y into dy is equal to minus y into dz. Okay, so here, I will divide this other side term, so we get here dz upon dy equal to, so dz upon dy is equal to z minus twice y upon y, which implies that dz upon dy minus z upon y, and here minus 2 y upon y, y get cancelled, so we get minus 2. Okay, so here dz upon dy is minus z upon y is equal to minus 2. So this is, what is the type of that differential equation? So here is minus sign, so after dividing other side we get minus, so here minus minus, here will get plus, and here minus minus will get plus. Okay, so this is linear differential equation, so this is the type of linear differential equation, that is we get here dz upon dy plus 1 upon y into z is equal to 2, so which is linear differential equation, linear differential equation. And we know that how to find out solution of linear differential equation, so this is term p of y, right? So this is the equation of the term dz upon dy plus p of y into z plus is equal to r of z. Okay, so this is the equation of the type this. Now its solution, how to find out its solution? Now find out its integrating factor, therefore which is linear differential equation in terms of z and y. So its solution, first find out integrating factor. So integrating factor has formula e raised to integration of p of y dy, so which is equal to e raised to integration, so what is our p of y, which is 1 upon y dy, so which is equal to e raised to log y, so e and log y, log get cancelled, so value will be y, and its solution will be, so what is solution, its solution is z into integrating factor is equal to integration r into integrating factor into what? Dy plus constant. So which is equal to z into integrating factor is y is equal to integration. So what is RHS? So 2 into integrating factor is y into dy plus c. So which is equal to, after solving, what will we get? So we get here z into y is equal to 2 into y square by 2 plus constant of integration. So here c1, c2, will take here c2. Okay. So 2 get cancelled. So we get here z into y minus y square is equal to c2. So this is another solution. So we call this as second solution v. Therefore we call this as v is equal to yz minus y square, which is equal to constant c2. Call this as equation number 3. So we get the solution yz minus y square. So this is another solution. Now from this method, or we can find from this method also, or we can find out z minus twice y into dy minus plus y dz is equal to 0. So from that we get here separating z dy minus twice y dy plus y dz equal to 0. So I can write adjusting z dy, so plus y dz minus twice y dy is equal to 0. So first two bracket can written as derivative of yz, right? Derivative of yz means what? Taking y as constant, then we get dz, y dz, and taking z constant, then we get derivative dy minus twice y dy is equal to 0. So after integrating, we get yz minus 2 into y square by 2 is equal to c2. That is y into z minus y square is equal to c2. So this is another method, or we can use linear differential equation in terms of z and y, and we get the solution, same solution here, z into y minus y square equal to c2, and here is z into y minus y square is equal to c2. So we can solve in any method. Now here, so this is another solution, therefore its solution is, so what will be its solution? F of u v is equal to 0. So what is our u? So our u is f of x square plus y square, and another solution is yz minus y square is equal to 0. So this is general solution of given partial differential equation. Okay, we'll stop here. In next lecture, we'll see some more examples. Thank you.